Dear students, welcome to the series where we are going to be talking about email etiquette. We are all living in the age of email. We know about it, that it is the most popular facility that is available through the internet. And it's relatively much more cheap to use as well. Because of this and these factors that are there accompanying the possibility of us to be able to write an email and have the better and effective working style adapted because of emails, we realize that this has changed the way people work in our industry nowadays and the way business proceeds. So we realize that there is a larger impact of email on the business as well. What is it that you have to keep in mind while you are working, and emails have to be coming in handy in use? You must make sure that you check your emails regularly and deal with the snail mails. Many a time we find that our email spam box is full of various emails that have been forwarded. Make sure at your end when you are working, you are forwarding emails to the people who really need to be reading those emails. And while you are drafting the email, correct your mistakes before you hit the button send. It's always better to check at your end before you make sure that other people get to read your mistakes and point it out to you. While working with the email requires developing a good memory, we understand that it is easy for us to go back to the conversation which we have been having earlier, and you can always go and look up at the trail mails as well. Yet at the same time, while you receive email, the conversations that you have, your latest agenda meetings will also be very clearly notified. Right? So email therefore enable people to work from home as well more effectively, and in the current times as well, in the times of pandemic, we have been able to see that effective emails have helped and made it much more easier for people to look at the traditional office costs being reduced, leading to more and more increase in the number of virtual workers. Now while we are working at and it requires concentration, we must make sure that you switch off your email alert. A lot of times the ping noise will only distract you from the more focus that is required while you are to work. Now there is a fun fact that here I would like to share with you. As you can see on the screen, you realize that current statistics show that there are around 210 billion emails being sent every day. That means more than 2 million emails per second. And get this, approximately 70% of them are probably spam and viruses. So genuine emails are sent by around 1.3 billion email users. Let's also look at the consequences of emails that have been sent. Now there are two divisions for it. One is internal consequences and the other one is external consequences. While you have to communicate, it is one of the forms wherein you can directly communicate with any person in the organization. We knew about it that usually communication process involves upward flow of direction of the information, downward flow of information, or horizontal flow of information. While the email facility allows you to communicate with the higher authority as well as the lowest authority in your organization. Thus, this organization structure is now called as the flatter organization structure, which has helped increase the transparency of your organization. There is new power that employees have been able to find with the advent of emails and more increase in sending of an email, in the transactions that are happening, in the way the information has been exchanged. Now, efficient information is distributed very quickly at a very fast pace with reference to emails. Now the external consequences that we have been able to notice is that you have a better relationship with the customers, and the co-workers also feel much obliged and much better with the direct form of communication that has begun to happen now. The productivity therefore has been enhanced manifold. Now we realize that external email message is also acting as an ambassador of your organization. The language that you use, the structure that you use, actually is very representative of the values that your company holds. It also leads to an impact on your reader's ability to pick up the main points from your email. So as you can see here in the diagram that is there, that there are certain important things to be noted in a written message that you have in form of email. Your language, tone, layout and structure shall be given much more importance, and careful drafting. And we are going to be discussing about that in the coming series as well. Let's firstly look at why email is preferred choice for written communication. Firstly, because it is written, it is documented, you can go back to it and verify it. So that is why it is important. Secondly, it is time zone friendly. You can send an email to anyone sitting anywhere, and the person can receive and respond as per the time that suits them. It could be sent to different countries as well. It is quick as well. It's cheap, very, very friendly in terms of the internet and other telephonic conversations that you've had. Let's also look at it that it is also flexible. You have this option of scheduling to be sending an email. Those facilities have helped you utilize an email, draft an email as per your time of convenience, right? So you can also have the facility of attaching various files that are important, documents that you wanted to share with the employee or with the person concerned. It is also non-intrusive. Nobody else will be intervening in between. Many a times when we have conversation, there are multiple channels which one has to go through. Now, when you talk about email, it is referring to direct communication. You can also write an email to your boss directly stating the problem, that if there is any. So, and then not many people will be intervening. So, your point of view is very clearly communicated because of email. It can also be prioritized. You have various options there on the email wherein you can put a star and make it on an urgent basis, treat the matter urgently. You can schedule the emails accordingly. So you can deal, make separate folders as well within the email box that is there. The best thing is that you can also look at the history of each of the communication that you had. So many times when you talk about maintaining a record, emails are a very handy procedure for you to go back to the conversation and find out the history by using the search option as well. Therefore, we realize that email also enhances your efficiency. It helps you connect with the people and information in a much better way and on the better platform. It helps to improve the project management that you have in your organization. It helps in team building by writing emails of greeting and warm regards and celebration. You are helping building a community within your organizational structure. Then you have global communication. When I refer to global communication, you can talk about one country corporate person who is sitting in one country can be easily able to correspond to the other person in another country. It helps you have a better record. So while you have to manage records, while you have to manage files, it's easy for you to save your emails and have the soft copy maintained. Then virtual meetings can very much be arranged via email. Then collaborative work efforts have increased again further because of email efficiency. Now what do we realize? Let's just sum up quickly whatever we have learned in today's session. We have realized that there are certain startups in making the most of the email that we have. The first point is that you can adapt your communicative style while you are to develop your email. We will also be looking forward to a detailed session on this adaptive communication style. Make an email work for you, not against you, right? Use an email to enhance your reputation and your organization's image, as you are the ambassador and your email that you are sending is a representative of your, is acting as a representative of the organization. Switch off your email alert when you need to concentrate on another project. Consider making a phone call to a client. Many a times that might help you resolve an issue more efficiently than using an email. Enhance the relationship with the colleagues and clients by using email effectively. Pay attention to the tone, language and structure of email, as these impact your reader. Don't let email be a replacement for communication. Make sure it is only a tool to enhance your communication. When emailing across cultures, keep your language simple and your sentences very short and brief. That's all for today. While we are to discuss other details, other nuances of writing better emails in the coming sessions. Till then, keep writing better emails. Thank you.